Ramana Das, making videos on lifestyle in Germany, higher education in abroad, travel diaries and much more. So if you like my content, please do like, share, subscribe my channel. And without any further ado, let's get started. So basically today is the date I'm going to Switzerland. So my relatives, that my sister-in-law basically stays there. So yeah, so I'm going to visit them and I thought of showing you or carrying you people along with me in the journey and will show you like how I travel from Germany, from Munich to Switzerland during the Corona times and what are the restrictions that I have to follow. Yeah, so basically I had booked my tickets from Deutsche Bahn. So this is an app where you can book your tickets, regional tickets, or like from one country to another country. So yeah, and guys, if you want to go to any country, please book your ticket 1 or 2 months prior, because the cost of the tickets are getting higher once the dates are getting close. So please book your tickets prior, you will get it cheap. Like for me, I got my tickets off only 23.40 euro, just like it's per route. Like for going it's 23.90 euro, and for coming also it's same. But yeah, but it's a long journey because I have a lot of stopover. I'm not going to Zurich, I'm going to a small city in Switzerland which is known as Basel. This is very beautiful. If I get a chance, I will definitely show you the city too. Yeah, so that's why I have to like take a train from Munich to Augsburg first, and then Augsburg to ULM, and from ULM to Basel. So please wish me luck that I won't miss my train and can reach there safely and timely. Yeah, and regarding the Corona restrictions, so basically Switzerland doesn't have any restrictions as of now for going by train from any European country. So you don't have to do any test, or if you are not even vaccinated. But Germany has restrictions. So while coming back, if I'm not vaccinated, then I have to do a Corona test, and that should be RT-PCR or antigen test. If it's antigen test, then it should be like within 48 hours, and if it's RT-PCR, then it should be within 72 hours. So yeah, so I had done my, but although for the safe reasons, I had done my antigen test, so that if by chance the border police ask me, I can show them. And I had also done my vaccination. So I will stay in Basel for 14 days, and vaccination proof is valid after 14 days of your like jab. So while coming, I can show them my vaccination card to the Germany border security force. So yeah, so that are the rules, and you will get all these rules in an app and in also the different government sites of Germany and Switzerland. I will put all the links below in the description box where you can see the Corona travel restrictions for both of the countries. Yeah, so let's start the journey.
Munich Hauptbahnhof. The U-Bahn was late. Yeah, and now I'm waiting for my train. Finger crossed, guys. This is my first travel in Europe, so I hope I can reach safely. Yeah. Journey, guys. I finally sat on my Basel train, and the journey is not at all easy. I will discuss what happened to the train and what are the schedules of the train over here. Yeah, but finally I got into my Basel train, and I'm quite happy about it. So I brought my food from home, and yeah, and I will have my lunch now. I'm too hungry. it's of effort to cross so many trees. So yeah. So this is my food, and I'm basically eating some dal, rice, and some aloo. Yeah. So guys, finally I sat on the train. Previously I was sitting on a different seat. I was a bit nervous to do a video over there because people were looking at me, and I started vlogging. I am new to this vlogging thing, so I am quite conscious that people are looking at me or checking what I'm doing. So it's a bit weird. So now I got a seat where, yeah, just I am sitting, so I can vlog now. I can shoot some videos of the good sceneries, because it's like the scenario outside the window is mind-blowing. It's incredible. I will take a lot of shots. I hope I can take a lot of shots, although I had my lunch. And yeah, and now I will just enjoy some music, some scenic beauty. Yeah, so yeah, so I will, so please, so let's see what more we can do. And yeah, feel like some DDLJ sort of feeling, you know. Yeah, but yeah, they really look beautiful. This, I just love this green thing. So we came to our next station, that is Bad Schussen Ride. Yeah, and it will take me 3 hours to reach to Basel. So right now I will do nothing. I already had everything, my food, and I'm full now. I will just chill, maybe I will sleep. So yeah, so that's it. Guys, it's 3:17 p.m. now. I'm still on the train. It's quite tiring. Yeah, so I'm just sitting, hearing some music. If there is Wi-Fi, then, although the Wi-Fi is there in the train, but it doesn't work that well. So yeah, so that's all. That's the update. Now I will see you after, when the train reaches to Basel. So I reached, but the train entered Switzerland. I'm into a different country now, and Switzerland is really beautiful. You can understand like why Switzerland is so famous in Europe. It's so perfect. I can't exactly show you the beauty now because it's on my opposite side. My side, there is nothing very special, but yeah, like, it's really good. I will reach my destination within 17 to 20 minutes. Yeah. Hey people, so finally I'm in Switzerland, and it's basically, I think, day 3 in Switzerland. Yeah, and I finally thought of like briefing you my whole journey from Munich to Switzerland. It's not at all an easy journey, although my tickets were super cheap. And I don't want to spend a lot of bucks in my ticket, so I did not take a direct train. My train journey was basically a connection train. So my first train was from Munich. I already told you like from where I booked and what was the corona restrictions. So I first booked my train from Munich to Augsburg. That is an ice train, and yeah, and it took me almost like half an hour, and the train was on total on time. and I had a 10 minutes break, and from there, from Augsburg to Ulm, I had another train, which is an I think IRA train. So the 10 minutes break was totally fine because the platform was near. I had to just go from platform 5 to platform 6 or 7, so it was very smooth. But the train from Augsburg, that is the ULM train, I had a gap of 27 minutes, like from Augsburg to ULM and then ULM to Basel. So from ULM to Basel's train and from Augsburg to Ulm train, there is a gap of 27 minutes. So I thought that okay, I was not very much scared about that. But the train got late. Like in Augsburg, the train was 10 minutes late. Finally, I got into the train and there was like full of crowd. It's like a local train. Because I think any previous train got missed or delayed, so many people were there. I was totally standing, and in one of the station in the middle, the train got stopped, and I was like panicking because I'm going to miss my next train. So everybody was running to a different train, so I also ran with the crowd, and thank God I ran and I got into a different train which took me to the Ulm, and I just had it time difference of only 5 minutes, guys, only 5 minutes. Yeah, and I had to catch my train, and my platform was from platform 27 to platform 8. I literally ran like anything. I was lost of breath, but thank God I got into the Basel train and it was on time. The scenic beauty on the train journey was breathtaking. It was world. And then I had a smooth 3 hours train journey, and I came. Although the last train was also 5 minutes delayed, and maybe that's why I got into the train. But I think I will advise everybody that it's better to take a direct train to Zurich and then took a train to Basel. That would be easier. You will not be that much tensed. But yeah, if you want to have a cheap ticket, then you can't do. You have to take this sort of breakage or connection ticket because it only cost me 23 euros, which is super cheap. Yeah, so finally I got here and it was really good. I went to a lot of places. Yesterday I went to La Solitate. I will again clarify the name. Maybe I will put the name somewhere here. Yeah, and it was a breathtaking beauty. The roads in Switzerland was really good. Right now it's windy outside. And yeah, and it's really nice. I went there, I have some kebab and stuff, so it was very, very good. Munich is definitely good, but whatever I saw in Switzerland yesterday, the roads were very different. It will give you that, you know, that typical DDLJ feeling, greenery all over on the both the sides of the road. There is lake, there is mountains. So it's all in all, it's really good. So that's all my journey, like how I came from Munich to Switzerland, and the same train will take me from Switzerland to from Basel, that is in Switzerland, to Munich. Yeah. So if you have any more questions regarding any corona travel within the European country, you can comment me, and please do not forget to like, share, subscribe my channel. Yeah, till then, bye-bye, see you.